As I'm walking up the stairs to the second floor of my house, I enter into an eternal September. Everything outside is in an eternal fall state. It's raining and the trees are orange. On the last stair, there's a giant compact computer door, which I discovered after running a Turing test, has a basic personality and is happy to see me. It barks like a dog and opens a large compact door. I enter the door and I see Alf on the floor. Having a breakdown from overeating. He has food all over him, and the wooden floor is stained from all the food that he has eaten. No one is paying attention to him because of a vile fury spell casted from the lights in the ceiling, which makes everyone in the house forget about the value of material goods like the floor. Having the stairs behind me, I turn right and I walk into my sister's room. She has decided to make a sugar sculpture, and there are empty packs of Domino's sugar everywhere, on the desk in front of me and on the sofa on my left, and even on the bed where she's laying. She has a computer over her, and she's covered with sugar and empty Domino packets. I exit the room and enter my parents' room, where naked alternate universe versions of Ryan Thomas Gosling were popping out of a multiverse portal in the bookcase behind the bed. Backing out of my parents' room, on my left, I enter my room, and on my computer, which is on my desk, all my files are replaced with cute images of puppy Bedlington Terriers. Behind the desk, there is a window with a view of the neighborhood houses. Throughout the window, I see the neighbor's house where instead of a pool, they have Lake Baikal, which is a platonic ideal of a banana. The neighbors are having a pool party at the lake. Everyone is in crazy swimming costumes, and there is also a magician in a swimming suit performing on a gondola over the lake, so all of the guests can see him. The room on my left, next to mine, is my brother's. In there, together with my mother's help, he's trying to transform his desk into a perfect, smooth, oval shape by using vibratory tumbling. Holding hands, they had both agreed to make it as best as they can. They were working so well, together and very hard at the same time, that the oval shaped desk had reached a large index of refraction. Due to the constant vibratory tumbling, the wooden floor of the house had turned into burning embers.